Vedita Sitar from Laundry Basket Quilts. Welcome to Quilting Window. I am so happy you took the time and wanted to quilt with me today. Thank you so, so much. Well, today I have a special surprise for you. This class is going to be wonderful. Did you ever wanted to make a beautiful house block and you just didn't know where to start it, how to cut the pieces, put things together? Well, I'm going to be here for you today. Let's make a block from this beautiful blue barn quilt. Isn't that stunning? It's a simple schoolhouse block, and we're gonna make a one together. If you can make a one, you can make a dozen. Let's do it. So first, let's see what's in our quilting basket. This wonderful quilt can be made with any blue and white scraps. I like to use fat eighths or fat quarter bundles. Out of one fat quarter, you get two houses. Those are fat eighths. So I get a one house out of each of the fat eighths. I also have put in my basket a beautiful light collection. This called signature style. Perfect for backgrounds. So those are gonna be wonderful to work with it. If you would like to, this is a royal blue fat eight. We are also expecting right now, it's coming to the shop, our perfect union. Look at those beautiful blues. Look at it. Isn't that stunning? We're gonna have fat quarter bundles and yardage. This is perfect for this quilt. Wonderful. So I highly recommend it as they come in to get some. Now, what else I have in my little basket is templates. Those are brand new. When you get your templates, they're gonna have a paper on it. I'm gonna keep mine right away on the table. We're gonna cut it from those templates. You're gonna need a pattern. The pattern calls Blue Barn, or you can also find this quilt in our best-selling book from Martingale called Patches of Blue. Wonderful book, so many beautiful blue and white quilts. I'm gonna use a Aurifil thread, weight 50. I love my little hand pressing tool. I'm gonna put it right next to me. And my favorite, Macrotex needle, wonderful. And they are 70, very nice and thin, super fun for sewing. All right, we also gonna need a rotary and a ruler. Let's start by cutting. I'm gonna show you a little bit of cutting. I don't have to refresh with you, I believe, a cutting with just ruler, but I want to refresh with you how I cut it with my templates. So right there, I have my templates. Those templates are clear plastic, and you're gonna notice there is a writing on it. You want the writing to be right side up so you can read Blue Barn. Make sure that all your templates are positioned so you can read them, okay? So don't flip it on backwards because then your pieces are not gonna be matching. So I have it right there. You're gonna ask me, how am I gonna take this paper off? You just go ahead and gently pull it on the corner and look how quickly you can take that paper off. We keep the paper on your template so as they're arriving in your studio, they don't get broken in a shipping, and it protects so you get a beautiful, wonderful template. You can just throw that paper away, you don't need it. All right, this is the roof. It says Blue Barn on it. Perfect. I have my templates, and those are for the top part of the quilt, right here, of the block, right here. We need it for this part of our block. Super. So let's cut. I'm going to grab a piece of blue fabric. I'm gonna place it in front of me. This fabric is 4.5 inches. If you forget it, you can just place this template and measure from here to here, and I believe it's 4.5. You're gonna go ahead and start placing your pieces to cut. In the pattern, I know I'm gonna need a triangle and this rooftop, this triangle and the rooftop cut with my templates. I'm gonna start with the triangle. So let me put the diamonds to the side. I'm gonna go ahead, place my triangle right on the top of it, grab my rotary and cut it, and then cut it again. Look at how quickly, look at this. I cut my pieces perfect. First piece I cut, but my triangles are not only for cutting, but also for marking points where I'm going to be sewing. Notice on each corner, I have a little hole right there. So what I'm gonna do is, and you should be using your sew line fabric pencil, and this one is pink, so you can see it, or you can get the gray one. I'm gonna use a marker so that way you can see it a little bit better. And what I'm going to do is I just mark my sewing points, okay? Mark my sewing points, perfect. This is where I'm gonna put pins and pin my pieces right there. Can you see it? I use the marker so that way for this video, for camera, you can see it. Now, go ahead and put your templates to the side, grab your second template. Wow, this is gonna be so much fun. I'm gonna place it right over, match top, bottom, beautiful. This line was already cut, so no waste. I matched it up too, and I gently cut it, perfect. Now I just finished cutting the roof. Isn't that wonderful? So I have my pieces cut. Of course, again, let's take a template, mark, 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 and keep going that way. You will be cutting from the blue, then you would go ahead and take a light fabric, cut a strip, and from that strip, you will cut the remaining pieces. Notice there is a left and a right piece for each side. Right here for left and the right side of the roof. So make sure you cut those perfect. As soon as you finish cutting, we can go ahead and start sewing. I'm gonna clean up a little bit so you get to see everything else that I'm doing. All right, I have already cut my pieces and I have marked them as I told you about it. Okay, let me pull those pins. So I have all my pieces beautifully cut, and this part is quite important that you remember and do what I ask you to. So if you need it, let me grab this one more time. You place your templates, you mark it, perfect, mark it. Now I have nice marks on it, and I'm gonna go ahead and do the same with this one, okay? And mark it. Oh, don't let it move. That would be not good if I marked it wrong for myself. Oh, this is perfect. Now I marked it. Super. Can you see those little dots? What I'm gonna do is connect the dots. That's right. I'm gonna put a dot to dot right there, and I can pull it gently. Oh, look at, I can see that dots are right sides together. That's perfect. And I'm gonna put a pin right into the dot and just place it this way. And this side automatically matches up. Look at, my dots are matching. This is wonderful. I'm gonna again take a pin, pin it. Wonderful. All right, so this how I would place those pieces. That's great. I'm gonna start sewing from here straight down, and I'm gonna do the same thing with this piece right here. Make sure, draw a dot, dot, connect the dots right there. Notice how it overlaps right here. Make sure once you pin on the dots and you see how the pieces align, this is so important, because with first house or two, you get to see where those 2x4s are laying. So your house is being built exactly as it's supposed to. Again, pin it. Pin it in place. That's wonderful. Oh, this is gonna be great. Sew it. As soon as you finish sewing, you're gonna flip it open, flip it open. And what I did is I pushed the seam allowance towards the light right here. This seam allowance go towards the dark. This seam allowance will go towards the light as well. Let me show you. Right there, I sew all my three, all the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces all together. Let me flip this to the back so you can see it. This seam will go right there. Notice it, the seam goes right here. See, right there, beautiful, press it, and right there, wonderful. Those seams go opposite because I want a nice top of the roof right here. I don't want a lot of bulk so I can sew this and don't lose any of my points. So now I just finished the top of the roof. Wonderful. Another part of the block, I'm gonna leave it close to us, is the chimney part right here. I'm going to need, and those parts are all cut with rotary and a ruler, and they're super easy. You just have to follow the direction in a pattern and now cut your pieces. And we're going to need two chimneys, and now we need this one, and this one right here. You're gonna sew this to this, this to this, this to this, this to this. Push it towards the dark. Let me show you the magic of our videos. Ooh, this looks wonderful. Look at this. Let me show you from the back. All push towards the dark. Super. This is gonna be the chimney. Let's place it right here. We're slowly creating all the units that we need to make a house. Let's make this part right here for the house, the windows and the right here, the windows and the side. So let me grab that part. You're going to need light and light strip just like this. You're gonna need a top and a bottom, and you're gonna need two windows and a little bit blue in between. All those rectangles, all the measurements are in our pattern. So right there, you're gonna place those right sides together, sew it, flip it open, the same repeat on all the seams. As soon as you finish, you sew this to this and this to this, and then you're gonna go ahead and add beautiful the side right here, and then you're gonna add the top bar just like we have it in a pattern. Let me show you how I did. Oh, looks great. Look at this. Wonderful. Flip it back. Look at where the seams are going, towards the blues, towards the blues. Right here, the seam went towards the light and towards the light. Why? Because there are two seams right here that were pushing me, and it was very bulky, and this seam was pushing up. So now this looks wonderful. So I have this part done. Now let's put a door on our house. So excited. You need the top of the door, the sides left and right, and a beautiful light door. You're gonna sew this to this, this to this, at the top, press it, and in no time you have this beautiful unit. Look at how nice it looks. I flip it over for you to see it. The seam went up, the seams went towards the dark. Wonderful. Now I'm gonna go ahead and start sewing my units together. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. You need the 4 units done. And if I be making 20 houses, I will be making chimneys for all of them, roofs for all of them. Why? Because by repeating over and over and over and over the same task, your blocks going to be perfect. I'm telling you, once you learn where to pin it, you're not gonna even have to mark. You just have to follow that first little bit of where to go. Once you know where to go, you're good to go, and you don't have to do it over again. And the pressing, I gently press it with my little pressing tool so I don't stretch the pieces. This is wonderful. Okay, now let's take this one, place it right sides together, match it, sew it, flip it open. Wonderful. As soon as you finish, you're gonna go ahead and do the same thing right here. And it's gonna be important when you lay your block to make sure that you match the seam so we end up right there. This seam right here ends up matching. This is the important seam right here, matching, because you want your blocks to be really nice. So please make sure, put a pin right here, sew it, and that the same with the chimney. When you're placing it, I'm gonna show you this. Look at this. Can you see this? Yes, yes, let's look at this. Look at this right there. I would pull it back. Now this is wonderful. Let's put a pin in it. Do the same thing on this side for our chimney. Yep, wonderful. Let's put a pin in it and make sure you sew it straight up. Now flip it open. Perfect. This and this area you need to match with those seams, and because they're on an angle, you're not going to be able to lock it. You're just going to have to go ahead. Remember how I showed you? You're going to go ahead, pull it gently back, all matches. Now let's pin it. And because the seam allowance is pushed this way, you can feel it. You can see it where to pin it. Right there and right there. Sew it, flip it open, and look at this. In no time, you're gonna have a beautiful, beautiful house that you will be only proud of it. What a wonderful block. As soon as you finish your blocks, you're gonna sew a little sashing in between, sew your blocks into beautiful rows. If you would like to, you can add a little trees in between, and it makes a beautiful little winter village. I just love this beautiful pattern. This one calls Blue Barn, and all the direction paper templates are in a pattern, and the acrylic templates are something you want to get it additional if you would like to have it. I hope you enjoy it. Our beautiful Blue Barn. I had so much fun showing you the little tips and things that will help your quilting be even better. Thank you so much for stopping by. Please make sure subscribe to our YouTube channel. Give us thumbs up. We are so thankful for all your likes. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and make sure you visit our website at laundrybasketquilt.com. Thank you so much for quilting with me. Make a beautiful home and enjoy. Happy quilting!